The several stories of grief emerging through the pandemic are mind-boggling. In Karnataka, this 10-day-old baby's tragedy has left us numb. India Today's Nabila Jamal takes you through this unfortunate incident, this unfortunate news that comes from Mandya district in Karnataka.
5 days after this baby was born, COVID-19 made her an orphan. This heart-wrenching story is from Mandya in Karnataka, of a child who was yet to be named by her parents. For 9 years, Mamta and Nanjunde Gowda anxiously waited for a child. Finally, their prayers were answered and they were blessed with a cherubic child. But fate had something else in store. 5 days before she was born, her father, Nanjunde Gowda, died of COVID. Then the virus killed her mother. The infant too caught COVID, but quickly coped with treatment and is now stable at the Mandya District Hospital.
Clinically stable. It's not on any medications as such. It's a good weight baby, weighing almost 3.3 kgs. Doesn't have any complications. We have tested on day 1 and as well as day 5 of life for COVID, and both the test samples have come negative.
I just got a glimpse of the little child. She's doing fine, she's stable and absolutely beautiful, I should say that. It's so devastating to know that the child is left alone, both the parents have succumbed. The parents' family members say that they will come claim the child once they get all their RT-PCR test reports and they're negative. Then they will come and take the child home. But as of now, the child is left alone at the hospital. She's not been named. It's unfortunate. 9 years of wait, the family, in fact, the mother and father, Mamta and Nanjan Gowda, they waited for 9 years, prayed for a child to happen. Finally, the child was born. 5 days before she was born, the father passed away. 5 days after, the mother passed away. With both parents dead, the child will be handed to the State Child Welfare Committee after she is fit to leave the hospital.
The child is doing fine. She is at the district hospital. The first preference is given to the child's family, that means blood relatives. If they don't want to take the child, then the CWC will take decision for legal adoption. We follow strict adoption procedures.
The CWC, doing due diligence, first approached the child's father's family. Thankfully for this child, her mother's brother and his wife have come forward to adopt her, but will have to go through all legal procedures. They already have two children, these two lovely kids, and they're really excited to have the baby home. What have you named the baby? Have you named her?
Lavanya.
Lavanya? Are you happy?
Yes.
Yes? Which class are you in?
Fifth
standard. You're very excited. You? Khushi aagta idya?
Aadre avalu barlilla annadonde becha. Avala bandidre chenagittittu.
Yaar bandilla?
Naadni. Avalu jothele barbekittu. Pappu jothe.
Mamta avaru. Neevu close aagiddra avar jothe?
Destiny
has been cruel to Lavanya. The baby's potential parents are calling her. The infant is fortunate that a loving home awaits her. Nabila Jamal, Bureau Report, India Today.
Hospitals in Bihar are seeing a surge of patients and the healthcare system is in a shambles. Poor infrastructure and government apathy makes rural population more vulnerable to COVID-19. In this report, we are going to show you a story from a hospital in Purnia that's actually a cow shed.
Take a long, hard look at this structure. From all angles, this one visual tells you what has gone wrong in Bihar. What you're seeing on your screens is a hospital building in Purnia district. What was planned to be a modern health center now hosts cows. All around you will find fodder and cow dung.
ये है अस्पतालों की असली हकीकत बिहार में, जहां 6 साल से एक अस्पताल तकरीबन 65 लाख की लागत से बनकर तैयार है, लेकिन 6 साल से इसका उद्घाटन नहीं हुआ है, इसे खोला नहीं गया है, जिसकी वजह से जो आसपास के इलाके में रहने वाले लोग हैं उनको दर दर भटकना पड़ता है, शहर की ओर जाना पड़ता है, पूर्णिया जाना पड़ता है, मधेपुरा जाना पड़ता है इलाज कराने के लिए।
6 years ago, this building was constructed at a cost of 65 lakh rupees. But now, the Nitish Kumar government has probably forgotten this exists. This hospital does not even exist on papers.
दोष उद्घाटन में क्या है, इस अथी को ने दिया है, डॉक्टर ने आया है तो पेशेंट यहाँ से पूर्णिया कते कते जा रहा है।
बहुत ज़्यादा नुकसान हो रहा है, क्या कि ये हॉस्पिटल जो है अतिरिक्त प्राथमिक स्वास्थ्य केंद्र है, इसको जो है यहाँ पर ना ही डॉक्टर आता है, ना ही कोई जो यहाँ के प्रतिनिधि सब है, यानी कि विधायक हुए, MP हुए, किसी सब इसको इग्नोर करके चले जाते हैं, इसीलिए गांव का जो है ना सभी आदमी को काफी कष्ट उठाना पड़ता है।
Villagers allege they are paying the price for their political loyalties.
यहाँ की जनता और मुखिया दोनों राजद के समर्थक हैं, यहाँ विरोधी दल के MP हैं, विरोधी दल के विधायक हैं, उच्च वर्ग से आते हैं विधायक, और क्या कहते हैं यहाँ ये पंचायत जो पूर्णतः पिछड़ी जाति के लोग यहाँ है, ये यही समावेश में आकर के इसका उद्घाटन MP कर रहे हैं, अन्य कर रहे हैं विधायक।
इफ द बिल्डिंग वॉज फिनिश्ड, इफ द गवर्नमेंट हैड हायर्ड डॉक्टर्स एंड हेल्थ केयर स्टाफ, if there were medicines and facilities, this cowshed would have been playing a major role in Purnia's war against the virus. If only. With Rohit Singh in Purnia, Bureau Report, India Today.
It's being said that more than 1,600 teachers and support staff have died due to COVID-19 during panchayat elections in Uttar Pradesh. The unions have now demanded compensation for the next of kin of those who died. The government is saying only 3 teachers died during panchayat elections. Our Lucknow Bureau with this report.
When the second COVID wave was ravaging parts of India, there were the scenes in the rural areas of Uttar Pradesh. A panchayat poll held amid the deadly pandemic, with all COVID protocols openly flouted. The outcome was disastrous. According to the Uttar Pradesh Teachers Union, more than 1,600 teachers who were put on election duty died after getting infected with suspected COVID. But the government differs, claiming just 3 deaths as a result of COVID.
इसको लेकर लोग राजनीति कर रहे हैं। राज्य निर्वाचन आयोग ने इस प्रदेश के सभी जिलों के जिलाधिकारियों से जो सूचना एकत्र की है उसके आधार पर 3 शिक्षक हमारे ऐसे रहे हैं जिनकी चुनाव ड्यूटी के दौरान मृत्यु हुई है।
India Today hit the ground to verify the claims. Teachers Union in Lakhimpur Kheri claims 55 COVID deaths in the district. The union has given the local authorities a list of teachers who allegedly succumbed to COVID. They have demanded compensation and jobs for the families of the deceased. The administration has rejected the claims.
पंचायत चुनाव से लेके अभी तक जब से कोविड की महामारी फैली हुई है, तब से हमारे लगभग 55 जो है शिक्षक और 76 कर्मचारी हमारे जो हैं वो दिवंगत हुए हैं, और बाकी जितने हमारे शिक्षक एक्सपायर हुए हैं या 76 कर्मचारी एक्सपायर हुए हैं उनके जो देयक हैं उसके लिए हम लोग कार्रवाई कर रहे हैं।
In Unnao, 32 teachers allegedly died of COVID. The teachers have written a letter to the Chief Minister demanding ex gratia of 1 crore rupees to the victims' families.
जो परिवार कोरोना से पीड़ित हुए हैं, कोरोना वायरस के रूप में उनके परिवार से कोई या खत्म हुआ है, तो उन परिवार को कवर 1 करोड़ की धनराशि दी जाए। और बाली को नौकरी मिल रही है।
Next is District Jalaun, where 18 teachers died, allegedly due to COVID after panchayat duties. The local authorities, however, confirm only 12 deaths, attributing 8 to COVID and 4 to heart attack.
So total 12 teachers उसने मिली, जिनमें से हमारे 4 teacher heart attack से expire किए थे, बाकी 8 teacher corona positive से expire किए थे, लेकिन कोई भी teacher हमारा duty के दौरान expire नहीं किया गया।
The story in Etawah district is no different, where 8 teachers allegedly died of COVID. The teachers here too have demanded 1 crore rupees in relief and job for victims' families.
तो जितना मुझसे हो सकेगा वो पूरा कोशिश करूंगी कि किसी भी शिक्षक को किसी तरीके की कोई परेशानी ना हो, जो हो गई है उसमें हम उनके साथ पूरी तरीके से कंधे मिलाकर चलने की कोशिश करेंगे। विभाग भी मेरा पूरा सक्रिय है।
इस राष्ट्रीय कार्यक्रम में जो हमारे शिक्षक शहीद हैं, शहीद का दर्जा देना चाहिए। ये आपदा आई हुई है, पूरे भारत में, पूरे विश्व में ही है, उन्हें शहीद का दर्जा देकर कम से कम 1 करोड़ की अनुग्रह राशि एवं उनके आश्रितों को एक निश्चित समय में सारे देयकों का भुगतान और नौकरी जितनी जल्दी हो सके 1 हफ्ते 15 दिन ऐसा समय निश्चित करना चाहिए।
While the unions are insisting on relief for families of more than 1600 teachers who allegedly lost their lives to the virus, the Uttar Pradesh government has announced 30 lakh rupees to the families of 3 COVID victims listed in their records. With Kumar Abhishek in Lucknow, Bureau Report, India Today.
And in this part of Suffering Diaries, let me now take you to Mysuru, where the civic body is coming forward to help those who've come to say their final farewell to their loved ones. The administration is trying to ensure that they face minimum inconvenience.
The district of Mysuru has seen a steep rise in COVID cases amid the second wave. The death rate is climbing. Test positivity rate is also a worry. The district has so far recorded over 1400 deaths due to coronavirus. But the authorities are on their toes and have ensured people are not inconvenienced. Unlike the chaotic scenes outside Bengaluru crematoriums, there is a clear system in place that's ensured zero chaos. The Mysuru City Corporation authorities decided that in order to check crowding, a new electric crematorium was opened.
As per Mysuru City Corporation, we are doing it every free. No body charges, no ambulance charges, no service charges, nothing. We pick the body from the hospital as well as at home if it is a home death. We didn't have that queue system at all. We are having 4 ambulance that is free service, what we'd say. We are in 3 places also. We didn't face that queue system in Mysuru City.
When we arrived at the crematorium, 3 ambulances arrived carrying bodies. Here, the crematorium staffs unzip the body bag to allow the family members to get a glance of their loved one last time. The staff also performs the last rites in the presence of the family members who stand a safe distance away and watch.
One thing we decided early on is that we will do it in a very systematic way. So our one objective was to give respect to the dead, and we can't treat the bodies, you know, just like it is another sack. The team that we formed from the corporation was not just because they had to do it, but because they chose to do it. Even the field workers, ambulance drivers, people who lift the bodies, to people who cremate the bodies. So we formed a team who are actually volunteering and who are service oriented and service minded.
In the first week of May, when an ambulance driver fell sick and bodies needed to be shifted from the hospital to the burial ground, this officer wore a PPE suit and took over the role of the driver. We visit another crematorium in the district. Since the pandemic, over 1100 COVID bodies have been cremated here. Officials can't pat themselves on their back just yet. The active cases in the city are still high and the positivity rate in Mysuru is over 40%.
We are going to increase the number of tests and we'll ensure in all the primary health center the tests are conducted, the swab test will be conducted, house to house survey will be conducted and house visits will be done to ensure whoever is in home isolation, they'll get the best treatment. The people whoever is infected having all kind of symptoms, we are trying to reach out to them and create awareness. These are the COVID symptoms, please get tested immediately, and by getting tested immediately we can start the treatment and save their lives.
The BBMP can afford to learn a few lessons from the local authorities in Mysuru, who have ensured minimum inconvenience to people amid this pandemic. With Nolan Pinto in Mysuru, Bureau Report, India Today.
Junjunu in Rajasthan is also known as the land of the brave. It has produced many martyrs who made the supreme sacrifice for our country. There are more than 1 lakh ex-servicemen living in this district, and they are making sure that the ex-servicemen contribute to the fight against coronavirus. We bring you this report. India Today's Mosmi Singh is in Rajasthan. This is her report.
Sit-ups and push-ups and the duck walk. These are some of the drills that violators are treated with if they step out needlessly during the lockdown period. Junjunu is called as the land of the brave hearts. It's given many martyrs to the country. More than 1 lakh ex-servicemen live in this district, and they're making sure that they contribute to the fight against COVID by lending a helping hand.
You can see that here there are lots of ex-soldiers, ex-servicemen who are contributing in this fight day in and day out, distributing masks. That's the mask that you can see, giving kadha, and in fact helping the poor, and here maintaining a vigil right here at the crossroad.
Nimichand is heading this team of 20 ex-servicemen in Ghudagorji. He served the army for 29 long years, fought in Sri Lanka and served in Bhutan, and is now fighting the pandemic war with fellow civilians. A quick response team of 20 keeps buzzing around helping the needy and aiding the villagers. They also patrol and pull up the violators. These heroes travel in a vehicle with the sticker Corona Sena. They stop violators, help people selflessly. They haven't even gone home or seen their loved ones for weeks.
हम इसलिए कर रहे हैं कि हमारे गांव में कोरोना ना फैले, आने वाली पीढ़ी है वो अच्छी रहे, इसलिए हम ज्यादा से ज्यादा इनको घर में रहने के लिए पाबंद करते हैं।
हमने इस कोरोना को एक लड़ाई माना है और हम लोग एक्समैन इस लड़ाई को जीतना चाहते हैं। लड़ाई जारी रहेगी मैडम और हम जीत के दिखाएंगे इस लड़ाई को।
Putting in more than 12 hours on the field, they've been instrumental in bringing down the COVID spread in their village. And their selfless service has been appreciated by the district administration.
They fought the enemy for years, and now in the line of duty, fighting this pandemic, putting in everything that they've got to make sure that the country defeats this war against COVID, making really a difference on ground zero. This is Mosmi Singh with video journalist Satya Rothre and Naina Shikhawat on Ground Zero, Junjunu, for India Today.